Hello once again, everyone, and welcome back to this introduction to the UE4 editor video series. In this video, we're going to talk about scaling objects. So we learned about moving objects, we learned about rotating them, and last on our list of transform manipulation is done by scaling. So we have our basic project that we've been working out of here, created a new level and dragged in our starter content chair here. So I'm going to select it, and by default, we are in the move mode. I could press E to go to the rotation, which you learned about in the previous video, or I could press R to go to scale mode. You can also get to these from the toolbar at the top in the upper right-hand corner of the viewport. So we have move, we have rotate, and we have scale. To actually scale our object, we're going to click and drag on the axes that represent our X, Y, and Z. So again, it's color coded. Red is X, blue is Z, and Y is green. So to scale our object along the X, I'm just going to grab this red box here and drag it. And you can see we're creating a super long beach chair of sorts. So there's our chair. We could scale it in the opposite direction to make it a smaller chair, like so. We could also scale it along the Y here to make it wider, to turn it into a couch of some kind. Or we could scale it up along the Z to make it a little bit bigger as well. You can also scale in multiple axes at the same time just by clicking in the in between the two in the little lines here. You can see it's green and blue line there. So we're going to scale along the Y and the Z. Or we can do it along the green and red for the X and the Y. Back up so you can see that a little bit. Or we could also click the box in the center to scale uniformly along all three axes at the same time as well. The other method that we could use to scale our object is through the details panel. It's over here on the right. Currently we have some odd proportions here. We can go ahead and punch in some values. I'm actually just going to set these all back to one so that we are at our default setting. But if you wanted to scale your chair up to say three times its normal size, you could just punch in three for all of them, and you could see that we have a chair that is scaled up three times its normal size, preserving its integrity and not being skewed at all. One thing I forgot to mention, when scaling with the gizmo here, we can change the snap value in which we scale our objects, just like we could with the rotation and movement. So currently we are scaling at 0.25, but we can change these as well to any value that you'd like. You can also click the option to preserve non-uniform scale, or as well, you can actually turn off snapping altogether just by clicking this little icon here. And you can see we're getting a nice smooth motion as we're scaling. We're getting some funky float values here on our scale, but that's fine. If you want to just have something that looks like this, like a long beach chair of sorts. That's pretty much it for scaling. I did want to mention one more thing. Let's put this back to default here. So let's punch this back to one. In the other videos, we talked about movement and rotation for local versus world space. When scaling your objects, you are only going to be scaling in local space. So for example, if I select our chair here and I rotate it to its side, and then I press R to go back to scale, you can see that the gizmo, the scale gizmo, is already in local space. So we are scaling along the Z in local space here. We cannot switch this to world space. Otherwise, we would have really distorted looking chairs, which we don't want. If I went to rotation mode, if I pressed E, you can see we have access back to local versus world space. That's pretty much it for scaling. It's pretty straightforward. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we will see you in the next video.